Welcome to the Digium D80 IP phone training series, how to use your new Digium D80 IP phone video. In this video, you'll learn how to make and receive calls, place a call on hold, and transfer a call. When the phone is idle, you see the D80 home screen. To return to the D80 home screen, simply tap the home button in the toolbar. To make a call using the handset from the home screen, tap the keypad button. Use the number keys to enter the extension or phone number you want to call. You can then lift the handset or tap the green dial button to start a speakerphone call. To make a call using the contacts application, swipe from the left to right to access the navigation drawer. You may press the navigation drawer button to access the application menu. Tap the contacts button. This will access the contacts application. To locate the contact you wish to call, you may scroll up and down through your contacts. You can also tap the search button at the top right of the screen. Tapping the search button will reveal the search text box and display an on-screen keyboard at the bottom of the screen. You can search either by phone number, first name, or last name using the keyboard. To dial immediately, tap the blue number for the contact. To get more information about the contact, tap the name of the contact you wish to dial. This will open the contact's contact details card. Tap the dial button to begin the call. The screen will then display the caller's call card. To make a call using the favorites application, swipe from the right to left to access your favorites drawer. You may tap the favorites button on the toolbar to access the full screen favorites app. To locate the contact you wish to call, you may scroll up and down through your favorites. Tap the name of the contact you wish to dial. The screen will then display the caller's call card. If you want more information about the favorite, use a long press to open the contact's contact details card. Tap the dial button to begin the call. The screen will then display the caller's call card. There are several ways to redial a number. To redial your last dialed number, access the keypad by activating your speakerphone, headset, keypad button, or lifting the handset, then press the green dial button to bring up your last dialed number. Press the green dial button again to initiate the call. You can also redial from a list of previously dialed numbers by using the Dialed tab in the Call Logs application. First, swipe from the left to right to access the Applications menu. Then tap the Call Logs button. Tap the Dialed tab at the top of the screen. Tap the phone number to begin the call. If the entry has additional information, you may tap the name to open the contact's contact details card. Tap the dial button to begin the call. While a call is active, you can switch between the handset, headset, or the speakerphone, and your call will remain connected. During a call, use the handset, headset, or speakerphone buttons to activate that device. If you are on speakerphone or using the headset, tapping the button that matches your device will hang up the active call. Likewise, if the handset is in use for a call, placing it in the cradle will end the call. You have several options to choose from while you are on an active call. You can end the call, place the call on hold, transfer the call, set up a conference call, record the call, or park the call. You'll learn more about these options in the Digium IP phone training series. When you receive an incoming call, your ringtone will play, the message indicator light will flash green, and the screen will then display the caller's incoming call card. You can answer the call by lifting the handset. To answer the call using the speakerphone, tap the answer button in the incoming call card or the speaker button in the toolbar. To send the caller directly to your voicemail, bypassing all other call rules, tap the Send to Voicemail button. You may screen your voicemail while it's being recorded by the caller. Learn more about screening a call in the Digium D80 IP phone training series, how to use visual voicemail video. The transfer button can be used to send a caller to another extension or number with or without answering. If you receive an incoming call that you do not wish to answer, you can tap the ignore button. This will cause your phone to stop ringing and send the call to the next call rule. To place an active call on hold, tap the hold button on the caller's call card. The hold button will change to a resume button. There will also be a hold icon above the call time length on the upper right of the call card. To resume a call on hold, tap the resume button. When you are on a call and another call comes in, you will hear the call waiting tone and you will see an additional call card on your screen. You can answer the call by pressing the answer button. This will automatically put any other active calls on hold. You can navigate between multiple calls by selecting the caller's name on the cards. This will display the call card and the buttons for which actions you may take. Tap the resume button to speak to a party or the end call button to hang up. While you are on an active call, you may need to send that call to another extension or phone number. You complete this task by transferring the call. Following these simple steps, you can transfer calls to other extensions, to outside callers, directly to voicemail, and even choose whether or not you wish to announce the caller to the person receiving the call. There are two main types of call transfers. A blind transfer sends the caller directly to the person receiving the transfer. An assisted transfer allows you to speak with the person receiving the transfer before completing the transfer. The fastest transfer method is called a blind transfer. This method allows you to rapidly send a call to another party or their voicemail. An assisted transfer allows you to talk with the party you are transferring to before the transfer is completed. This process helps to facilitate a positive customer experience during the transfer. Transferring a call always starts by tapping the transfer button on an active caller's call card. The call is put on hold, allowing you to manage the transfer without disrupting the original caller. While on a call, tap the transfer button on the caller's call card. Then tap the keypad button on the toolbar. When the keypad appears on the screen, dial the extension or phone number of the person to whom you wish to transfer the call. To complete a blind transfer, tap the green Complete Transfer button on the keypad. Or, to begin an assisted transfer, tap the green Dial button, which starts a new call to your recipient. When you are ready to complete the assisted transfer, tap the Complete button on the new recipient's call card. If you wish to cancel the assisted transfer, press the End button on the new recipient's call card. You may then tap the Resume button to speak with the original caller, or enter a new extension or phone number to try again. While on a call, tap the transfer button on the active call, and then swipe from the left to right to access the navigation drawer. You may also tap the menu button to access the navigation drawer. Tap the contacts button to open the contacts application. Scroll through your list of contacts. You may also search to locate the contact you wish to transfer to. To search, either by phone number, first name, or last name, tap the search button. To perform a blind transfer, tap the name for the contact. This will open the contact's contact details card, where you can transfer to the contact's main number, other numbers they have defined, or their voicemail box. Tap the dial button, and then tap the complete button to complete the blind transfer. To begin an assisted transfer to your contact, tap the transfer button and then swipe left to right to open the applications drawer. Tap contacts to open the contacts application. Find your contact and tap the phone number for the contact you wish to call. A new call card will be displayed. If you wish to complete the assisted transfer, tap the complete button. To cancel the assisted transfer, tap the end button. You may then tap the resume button to speak with the original caller or start the process over to try again. If you have favorites set up with your often used phone numbers, then transferring a call is very easy. During an active call, tap the Transfer button to start the transfer. Next, tap the Favorites button from the taskbar, and then tap the Favorite key for the contact to whom you wish to transfer the call. This will start an assisted transfer to that favorite. If you want to use a blind transfer to send calls directly to your favorites, you can change the behavior of your favorites in your web user portal. To access the user portal, you will need your extension number and password. If you do not have this information, contact your system administrator. From the web user portal, using the Features drop-down menu, select Phone Features. Next, select the Rapid Dial Keys tab. Then, click the Digium Phone Options button. Set Blind Transfer Rapid Dial to Yes and click Save. The next time you start a transfer while on a call and tap the Favorites contact, it will send the call directly to the recipient using a blind transfer.
Thank you for watching the Digium D80 IP Phone Training Series, How to Use Your New Digium D80 IP Phone video.